The Health Department reports 4,479 new cases today, bringing the total to 1,408,000. 101 more patients have died. Over 6,000 more people have recovered. Active cases now at 50,000.
Metro Manila and its surrounding areas will stay under general community quarantine until July 15. But the restrictions will vary. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte preliminarily approved the recommendations of the country's COVID-19 task force, placing Metro Manila, Bulacan, and Rizal under GCQ with some restrictions. Laguna and Cavite, on the other hand, will remain under GCQ with heightened restrictions. More than a dozen areas will be placed under modified ECQ, the second toughest lockdown level in the first half of July. These include areas experiencing COVID-19 surges like Davao, Iloilo, and Puerto Princesa. Meanwhile, over two dozen areas will be under regular GCQ for the whole month of July. The rest of the country is under the modified GCQ, the least stringent quarantine level.
The governor of Cagayan welcomes the move to place a province under modified enhanced community quarantine. Governor Manuel Mamba says he will no longer appeal that decision to prevent another surge in COVID-19 cases. Mamba notes active cases in some areas are still high.
Gumawa rin po kami ng mga bagong initiative, katok apors, dahil yung mga apors na po ang pinanggagalingan ng mga ito. We're hoping na in the next 2 weeks ay mapababa pa namin ito ng gusto.
Puerto Princesa City, another area placed under MECQ, also approves the IATF decision.
Palagay ko okay na rin yon kasi although bumababa yung aming active cases, medyo mabagal ang pagbaba niya.
Malacanang says local government units have until tonight to appeal the quarantine classifications.
Philippine Chief Leopoldo Vega says government is implementing more aggressive contact tracing efforts and allocating more vaccines to areas that are high risk for COVID-19. According to Vega, these areas include Regions 5, 6, 9, 11, and 12, as well as the Carangay region. He adds the health department has sent additional healthcare workers to some of these areas. One hospital command centers have also been put up to coordinate healthcare facilities in regions like Davao and Caraga.
Kailangan ho ang compliance talaga ng ang ating minimum public health standards at saka yung detection isolation in less than 48 hours. Alam natin na if we can do that, mas maigi natin mapababa ang transmission ng virus. On the other hand, kailangan din natin ma-scale up rin ang vaccination process dahil alam natin ito din yung isang pamamaraan na magkaroon din ng population protection.
The Philippines extends its ban on travelers from India and six other countries until July 15th. This is the fourth time the travel ban was extended to prevent the spread of the highly transmissible COVID-19 Delta variant first detected in India. Also covered in the ban are travelers from Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, the United Arab Emirates, and Oman.
Binabawal po natin yung pagdating ng mga pasahero. In fact, meron din pong mga OFWs na papunta siguro sa mga ilang lugar na dyan. No? At hindi naman po sila napagbabawalan, pero pinag-iingat lang po. Again, alam ko pong napakahirap para sa mga OFWs na stranded ngayon sa mga lugar na kung meron tayong kung saan meron tayong travel ban, pero hinihingi po namin ang inyong pasensya at pag-intindi dahil ito naman po ay isang napatunayan ng paraan para mapigilan po ang pagpasok ng mas nakakamatay at mas nakakahawang Delta variant at Delta plus variant, no, na po pwede pong magdulot ng kamatayan o di naman kaya pagkakasakit, hindi lang sa inyo kundi sa inyong mga mahal sa buhay dito po sa Pilipinas.